Plants have a family tree stretching back nearly half a billion years. The first were slimy, thread-like algae that emerged from rivers and swamps to grow on the wet, muddy margins. Some developed watertight coverings that enabled them to move onto drier, though still moist, land. They were the liverworts. And the mosses. Later still, some of the descendants of those plants stiffened their stems so that they were able to stand upright as they reached up towards the light. They were the ferns and horsetails. This greening of the earth changed the course of life, allowing animals to follow plants out of permanent water. This cycad, for example, belongs to a family that certainly provided food for the dinosaurs. A major difficulty for plants in their new environment was reproduction. If they were to produce fertile seeds, pollen from one had to reach and fertilize the ova, the eggs of another. Conifers, pines, yews, and firs, then as now, used wind. They produced vast numbers of pollen grains, scarcely bigger than particles of dust, which the wind could carry for hundreds of miles. The technique was successful, but very wasteful. But then, about 140 million years ago, some developed a much more efficient way of doing that. These were the angiosperms, flowering plants. They diversified into a huge range of species, which have occupied almost every known habitat on Earth. Whether they are enormous or microscopic, are the basis of all life, including ourselves. We depend upon them for every mouthful of food that we eat and every lungful of air that we breathe. Ultimately, plants fuel the diversity of life on Earth.